Welcome back once again, and this time it is social study. I know that you are at home, you are in a holiday due to coronavirus, and we are encouraging you to stay at home. Stay at home, stay safe. Now today we are going to discuss or to have a little discussion concerning Tanzania culture. Culture as such, it is not something which is new to you. Since standard 4, standard 5, you have learned more about this. But in standard 6, we are going to have a deep discussion concerning culture, and our target is to know more and to identify Tanzania culture. Now, since standard 4 to standard 5, we have just learned that in Tanzania, we have more than 120 tribes. And every tribe's traditions, every tribe culture, every tribe customs and norms differ from one tribe to another. So we need to know Tanzania culture. In order to know Tanzania culture, we need to find those traditions, those customs and norms, those art and crafts which are practiced more by many countries, many tribes in Tanzania. And to know them, first you need to remind yourself concerning the indicators of culture, which are traditions, which are customs and norms, and which are art and crafts, and also language. Now, since I told you that our focus is to identify tradition, Tanzania tradition, then we are going to discuss about Tanzania traditions. Now, tradition, we say, are the inherited ways of living in a society which are passed from one generation to another. I believe you can repeat together, repeat after me. Traditions are the inherited ways of living in a society passed from one generation to another. I will repeat again that statement for you to grasp in your mind. Traditions are the inherited ways of living in a society passed from one generation to another. To call something that it is tradition, that thing needs to stay in our society for more than one generation. It needs to be passed on from the grandparents to the fathers, and from the fathers to the sons and daughters. It needs to be inherited from one generation to another. Now, how do they pass those traditions? The tradition can be passed on through imitations. When you talk about imitation, you are talking about copying the way someone do something. Children may copy the way fathers act. Children may copy the way fathers talk. Children may copy the way mothers cook. Now, the way those parents are doing, when they are copying those ways, then it means they are inheriting those ways to their kids. It means those ways can be called later on as traditions. Now, tradition also can be passed through word of mouth. It means those parents may talk to their kids, may tell them that you have to do this, you have to do this, and don't do this, don't do that. Now, if they are telling them what to do, and those kids, they are putting in their mind and they keep on practicing those areas where their parents are telling them to do it, means they are passing on their traditions. These are examples of traditions. We have initiation ceremonies. And in Tanzania, initiation ceremonies, we call them Jando and Unyago. We have tradition clothes. We have tradition foods. We have language, and also we have tradition dance. Now we shall have a discussion in one to another, from initiation ceremonies to traditional dance. Now, initiation ceremonies which are practiced in Tanzania, initiation ceremonies that are practiced in Tanzania, which I told you that we call them Jando and Unyago, as follows. Initiation ceremonies, firstly, are the celebrations that mark the beginning of a person's life stage. Initiation ceremonies are the celebrations that mark the beginning of person life stage. In Tanzania, when a child, a kid is shifting from the childhood to adulthood, we have the tendency of doing a celebration. Now, in that celebration, there are things we are teaching those kids to do when they are becoming adults. Now, those celebrations, that and those everything which they are learning in that celebration, that is what we call initiation ceremonies. In Tanzania, initiation ceremony is the one which mark the beginning of adulthood. Not childhood, but adulthood. And as I told you that it is called Yando Inyago. Yando are those initiation ceremony for boys. Those boys, when their boys are learning about how to act when they become adults, in that celebration we call it Yando. But for females or women, we call them Unyago. So for boys, we call them Yando. For girls, we call it Unyago. In Tanzania, not all tribes have these initiation ceremonies. But there are some which practice initiation ceremonies as follows. We have tribes like Kuria. We have tribes like Maasai. We have tribes like Gogo. We have tribes like Bulu. We have tribes like Kaburu. And also we have tribes like Ngoni. These tribes, they are still practicing these initiation ceremonies. Though it is not in large scale, but they are still practicing this initiation ceremony. Now, in this Yando and Unyago, there are teachings in which those people are learning, those kids are learning. And those teachings are the ones which help them to be better people when they grow up. Now, those teachings are, for example, love and respect for others. Love and respect for others. In Yando and Unyago, boys and girls are taught how to love each other, how to love the person who is behind them, how to love the person who is beside them, how to love their colleagues. They learn there, and also they learn how to respect not only others, but also how to respect their young one, or how to respect their age mates. They are taught how to greet in a respected way. They are taught how to talk to the elder adults, and they are taught how to respond to the age mates, and how to do when they are grow up. The purpose is to help them to be better people in a society. Another lesson they learn is self-reliance. In Yando and Unyago, they are taught how to have confidence on themselves when they are doing their things. How to have confidence in what they are doing. There in Yando and Unyago, they are learning about that. But also in Yando and Unyago, they learn about operations in virus undertaking. And whatever they do, they are learning how to cooperate with each other. How to do how to perform those activities together. They are also in Yando and Unyago, they are learning about that. And in Yando and Unyago also, they learn about the love for work. The love for work. They teach them how to have passion to do work. How to do work in a way that you can be a productive person in a society. In Yando and Unyago also, they teach them how to care for themselves, how to care for the way they wear their clothes, how to care the way they eat their foods, and which medicines they can use to help themselves when they become sick. And also, they are learning how to clean their environments and how to maintain or conserve their environments. In Yando and Unyago, they learn also how to solve the challenges they face when they grow up. Adulthood comes with changes in their body, especially for girls, they start to have changes in their body, and for boys also there are changes in their body. Now, in Yando and Unyago, they teach them how to act with those challenges, how to act with menstruation cycles, how to act when you find that you have beers, and how to act with those people of different gender. There in Yando and Unyago, they teach them to do that. And also in Yando and Unyago, they teach them how to love and care for the adults, sick, and also young people. Today we have covered only initiation ceremonies, and I'm going to issue to you the exercise which you are going to do for this part. But next time, we shall have a discussion more about traditions, clothes. Welcome back again. Thank you very much, and God bless you.